Hallelujah.
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 Hallelujah. I'm always very grateful. Each time on a day like this, I thank the Almighty God for giving me the honor and for all of you supporting me in this our Berachah yearly event. May God of honor continue to honor you and prosper you in your ways. We have about 30 or 40 minutes starting late, so I'm not going to waste too much of your time. My simple message this year to you will be very, very brief, and it's going to be as follows. The title, if you look at the banner, is to stay focused. Don't defeat. Just stand with Christ, and surely Christ will stand with you.
Amen.
Focus on your purpose and not your problem. There's a great difference between your purpose, what you hope for in life, and what the challenge, that's what them challenge. I don't see them as problem. But it depends on what interpretation, what definition you gave. And already was amazed at the nice young man next door. An old lady was amazed at the young man next door to her. Every day would help pack things from her car to help in her yard. Then one day, the old lady asked him, "How do you become such a very fine young man?" And the man replied, "Well, when I was a boy, I had a drug problem. When I was a boy, I had a drug problem." The old lady was shocked. "I can't believe that," the young man replied. "It is true, my parents dragged me to church every Sunday, and dragged me to church on Wednesday, and dragged me to church on Friday." I don't need to tell you, that is a letter. God bless you, sir. As I welcome you to this year's interdenominational crusade, stay focused. I wonder how many of us have this kind of drug problem. Thank God for that, my beautiful young granddaughter of mine. God bless you. Do we have to drag ourselves to church functions? Or we are hungry for God's word and the fellowship our church family provides? Hebrews 10:25. In our fast-paced attention, grabbing word, it is easy to get caught up in the daily grind, get distracted, yet we are told to run our race with our eyes focused on Christ. Hebrews 12:1-2. Something that we do in life do not require special attention on our part. We can successfully complete some tasks while we have music playing and talking on the phone at the same time other thoughts. Don't require us to be focused totally on what we are doing. Someone driving fast equipment must keep his attention on the task at hand. The same goes for a doctor that is performing a surgery. In many endeavors, losing focus can cause unpleasant results, even death. As Christians, which we are, we need to stay focused. We always need to keep in mind who we are, what our purpose in life is, and where we are headed. If we fail to keep our focus, we will soon get off course and into great spiritual danger. May that never be our portion.
Amen.
I have wondered for a very long time why people start to neglect church meetings and why people restrict their priorities to make church something secondary. I believe that it is due to a loss of focus. Some people make a partial commitment to God, partial commitment, not totally, but want God to be with us in all our endeavor. May God never desert us in our point of need.
Amen.
When we are God's people, we are going through difficulties due to our faith and the ungodly seek to prosper. We need to remember not to focus on them or even on our own difficulties. When you stay focused on your purpose, not your problem, you can be happy even when life seems to be falling apart. Paul was an old man when he was in prison in Rome. He was a long way from home. He was awaiting execution. Everything had been taken from him. His friend, his freedom, his ministry, even his privacy, with a guard chained to him 24 hours a day. What a terrible situation. It wasn't exactly a happy time for Paul, but there was one thing they could not take away from his purpose. There's one thing they could not take away from him. Paul made the choice to stay focused on his purpose, even when he had lost everything else. What was his purpose? What is my purpose? What are your purpose in celestial job? Serving God by serving others. Serving God by serving others. Not to be selfish. Let us be our brother's keepers. Philippians 1:22-25. You cannot control what other people do to you. You cannot control what other people do or not do, but you can control how you respond. One of the secrets behind the Apostle Paul's achievement in life was his absolute focus. His statement, "None of these things move him," Acts 20:24, means that none of his difficulties, persecutions, and problems he focused, he faced, will persuade him to walk away. I'm going to tell you a story about this in a short time. When we have the devil with even a small peg in our life, he will return to hang the slotting garbage on it. There are certain things in life, and certainly in our eternal life, that can be negotiated. If you are going to quit or start something, committing to hard work and sacrifice are essential. Certainly, this is true in relation to our commitment to Christ. He wants all of us without compromise or negotiation. That means our time, talent, and treasure. It may be comfortable to leave the door open just a little bit to our old man, but give the devil a toe in dog and he will most certainly put away in altogether. There's no place for compromise in a committed life. Today we will see from Psalm 37, 4-7, what commitment is and how to make sure that ours is a concrete commitment, not just something casual. Trust in God is the beginning of having a concrete commitment. And that needs to be a solid trust. It needs to be a faith that God described in His most holy word, and not what we give lip service to God. Define faith like this, Hebrews 11:1. What is faith? Is the confidence assurance that something we want is going to happen. Maybe so in Jesus' name.
Amen.
It is the certainty that we hope for is waiting for us, even though we cannot see it up ahead. That is what people who live by faith do. They remember that feelings can be misleading, but the truth in God words are reliable. Trustworthy and consistent, the Christian life, like walking on water, is humanly impossible. It can only be lived by the power of the Holy Spirit. Storms are going to come. When you are in a storm, with the wind raging and the wave pounding, and you feel like you are sinking like this, the same Lord still the storm, allow the storm to stay. How is your focus today? I was struggling recently to see through a narrow pair of glasses. The best of teachers made them, but they were all still a bit busy. I found out that the blood vision was not caused by the glasses, nor my eyes. It was just one of the nose parts that had got bent. After a tiny correction, the world was all clear again. How clearly are you seeing God these days? Crystal clear, bright and empowering. Or has God become blood over the days and weeks of life that has gone by? As we open to Isaiah 33, 14 to 17, we see the continual effect that Isaiah's sight of God has upon his life. We are reading this article ourselves. If you are ready to make a total commitment to Christ, a commitment that is much more like concrete than it is a cultural commitment, great people in grace, in spite of distractions, know how to keep things focused. They know how to inspire and motivate others to keep pushing. The main effect, they don't let side issues overwhelm them. So stay focused and have a blessed Berachah 2017. May God bless you.